So you made it to the bad side of town, eh? I won't ask what the Sabbat made you do to get here. As long as you help me cut some slack on this collar the prince still has around my neck.
Hi, good to see you. Ready to give me the loadout? What's the plan?
Just one problem. I might have exaggerated, just a little, about the whole getting you through this mess bit. There's no plan whatsoever.
Great! What are you talking about?
Look, my relationship with the prince is clumsy at best. I'm doing the bare minimum to survive. To be honest, I care more about my street art than whatever the fuck LaCroix decides his priority is this week. You might want to consider the same. Dude, I'm too busy getting stoned to fight your battles for you. Smart enough to keep my eyes open, though. That's just survival. So I can tell you who's who and what they're up to, but after that, man, you're on your own. Good news for you is you couldn't have picked a better time to come fuck with the Sabbat. The Hood's bishop just took a dirt nap. So now, every Sabbat with an ounce of influence is squabbling to stake their claim to that power. It's Sabbat politics. Don't ask me. The point is, the big bad Sabbat want to be bigger and badder Sabbat. They'll stop at nothing to sink their greedy fangs into the power they'd have over the local Sabbat packs. And you can bet they're about to turn on each other. Lucky you, here just in time to play one pack off another. Yep. The more things change, right? Sabbat are really not that different from the Camis. They're just a little more open about being totally awful.
Wanna give me some tips?
You're infiltrating, remember? Go talk to the top brass. Victoria in the projects. Hazel at the church. See what's making them tick. Help them out if you can. Gain someone's trust. But be ready to put a knife in their back the second they turn on you.
I got some serious questions, Jesse.
What's up?
Second thoughts. Nah. My head's asleep. Hi, guys.
So, This is the prince's newest plaything. This is the one everyone thinks so much of. I wonder if Andre played a joke when he called to say you were coming. You look ragged and soft, like a child's juguete, used up and discarded. Is there even any fight left in you, eh? Name's Victoria. But until you earn a place in the Sabbat, Lick, you call me Ductus. I know who you are, but what I'd really like to see is whether you can even bear those fangs. Or did the Camarilla leave you so spineless you could never stand among the Sabbat? Nina, if you can keep my pack and I laughing at your jokes, perhaps you have a chance after all.
Yeah, I'm dying of laughter. Come and get on with this, please.
Espera, gringa. That's not how this works. You don't walk into my house and expect to eat at the table. Sabbat doesn't work like you soft, gullible Camarilla putas. No. First, you'll chase scraps. First, I need to see how far you'll go to please me.
I get it. Let's work up the ranks. What do I need to do?
Don't worry. My boots only need so much licking before I know you're worthy to hold our sword. Until then, my problems are yours. And there's one for which I need an outsider.
Name it.
You've met the Mac, yes? Tiene la sombra. Kind of a small-time alcahuete. Pimp. He keeps a house down the street and a few girls. He operates here freely, but he makes some money. No es me importa, pero one of his girls, Immortal, she's of interest to me. The chains he keeps her with are not the kind you can see, but I want her free from his bondage. You'll be the one to change his mind. It's not your concern. You're not here to ask questions. Just do what you're told.
All right. It might help if I knew why you couldn't convince him yourself.
I don't put my nose in the shit directly. You're convincing him, so I'm convincing him.
That's an idea.
Because he's Sabbat, we don't steal from each other, and we don't maim each other. Not if we don't have to. A child of those deceitful Camarilla pendejos. I don't expect you to understand what having a shred of honor looks like.
I'll see. Alright, I'll do it.
Bueno, se llama Ariana. She used to live here in the nest among the pack. Do what you must, but get her home in one piece. Do this and you'll have my attention.
Oh, that looks like a church. There's that big red triple. Thank you.
Who does this wretch think he is? No! No one, mortal or otherwise, is going to take our church from us. I'll tear out his liver to feed the faithful. I'll slice his... Oh? What's this? Our minds were occupied. What do I behold here? Fresh, sweet blood. Word of your lust for communion amongst the true progeny of Cain has spread far and wide. Yes, your unholy arrival has been anticipated by many, myself notwithstanding. It's clear from the glassy, wayward look in your eyes, you seek the kind of faith that means something to you, more than just old words in an old book. You came to receive Hazel's blessing, of course. A blessing from us is no small thing, girl. But do you know, no reward is so great as true faith. Yes, yes. Perhaps you could earn our blessing. Child, you were born into this world retching with original sin, fallen. By your hands, our brothers have suffered greatly. But Hazel has a plan for all that seek his absolution. Perhaps this fall was a blessing. Fallen now, you have a chance to rise again amongst our ranks, amongst our pack, to become a brother amongst brothers. Though I tell you, talk is cheap. It will take more than wasted words, no matter how eager, to pay your tithes to me. I'm talking about that pillar of flame you brought down on the train yard. The one that sent our dear bishop to oblivion. But perhaps I owe you my thanks. With the bishop gone, Hazel Tomes has an opportunity to ascend to his rightful place amongst our brothers. This church, this hat? Don't mistake me for some foolhardy, hypocritical holy man chasing after the wasted blood of some false prophet that never was. Titles and names are just empty, profane words that don't mean a thing but to those so stupid, so null, not to see the eminence of Hazel Tomes. Power, real power, needs no words. And it's well past the hour for this broken world to see my grand vision. Child, coming from the clutches of the Camarilla, our thirst may seem depraved, chaotic even, but I assure you, our strength comes from structure. We're all equals, but some of us are more equal. Myself, for example, they call a ductus. I stand on the shoulders of my brethren, my pack, and upon my shoulders stand the feet of the bishop who leads this parish. But you see, that weight has been lifted. And I am not eager to bear it again.
So all three of you want a piece of the pie. Get out of my head! So, you want to be the next bishop. What's in it for me?
Power can be its own reward. When I am made bishop, I will not forget those that bore my weight proudly and strongly. Is it anarchy you crave, girl? Will it be you to stand alone against the hunters, the soldiers, and the lawmen with their rifles and flames? Our meals bite back. In our structure is strength. Strength to fill men's hearts with fear, to make cattle mild and meek.
Okay, I get it, okay. What do you want?
Before any such ascension, I propose a trial, a test. To prove your loyalty to Hazel Tomes and my own. You see our humble chapel here? Not all appreciate its glory. Some would threaten us with legal action. Ha! What action could stand in the terrible light of our divinity, hmm?
Oh, you're loving your voice accent, aren't you? What do you mean, legal action?
Look at this letter. This worm in a suit came by today. Says the city has plans to knock our sanctuary down. First, they came with smiles and handshakes, offering to buy it. Now they come with cutting threats. They would have us believe that the dollar is greater than faith. That what my flock here needs is a shopping center. They say they'd bring the authority of man to remove me and my congregation by force, if need be. Would that I could. But the last thing my parish needs is more attention from these crusading cattle. What a miracle it would be if this problem disappeared of its own accord. Or rather, your accord. Move! After all the work that I have done here, I have spent years spreading my gift of gospel to the faithful, building a symbol of strength, of power, out of the broken things, the wasted things that this city's would-be rulers leave unpolished. This place is the foundation of a new age, and it will not crumble at the whim of some besuited Herod. My faith has provided me the answer I sought. Find this fool and find his end. And before you're done, find why this cursed city seems intent on swelling the earth up itself to swallow our chapel. Return to me when the deed is done, and I will see to it that your presence in our order is a lasting stain. Their ringleader keeps an office not far from our sanctuary. They threaten not only I, nay, such a grandiose secular altar of consumerism would threaten the whole of this community. A garden needs weeding to grow. I command you to tear this fool from the earth with righteous fury.
Sabbat. I think someone said there was
thank you. Sorry, no clients right now. Trying to wrap some things up. Have to come back tomorrow.
Sorry, but our business can't wait. It's a matter of life and death. My life, your potential death.
The hell is that supposed to mean? You threatening me? This is East LA, you moron. You think I'm not prepared to deal with some small-time punks like you?
Put the gun away. I'm not here to threaten you. But your life is in danger. I'm here to help. But you have to listen.
Okay. Talk fast then. Before I change my mind.
Why are you just trying to destroy the church down the street? Time and time again you've tried. It can't be worth it.
Are you kidding me? It may not be prime real estate now, but I see something everyone else has missed. I've seen this before in East Hollywood. I've seen it in Brooklyn. This neighborhood is about to get the yuppie treatment. This shitty barrio is about to blow up. I'm gonna make a killing when I finally clear-cut that whole block. That
can't be right.
I've looked it all over, up and down. You think I'm some kind of idiot? I don't know who sent you or what you're trying to get from manipulating me, but I think you should just leave before someone gets hurt.
Wait, you really have no idea, do you? Just look at your notes again. You screwed it.
Oh, really? I'm not some clueless amateur when it comes to real estate. Take a look at this appraisal and tell me, wait, you're right. None of this makes any sense. I've made a terrible mistake. I'll be bankrupted. Ruined. Someone must have tampered with my paperwork. Altered some records. It's the only way.
Something is definitely fishy here. But it was your mistake just the same. This could really hurt your reputation. You need to put some distance between yourself and this project, like maybe a few states between you and here. Trust me.
You're right. I think I need to get out of this town and never come back.
That's what I wanted to hear now. Why don't you be on your way?
I see you've come to haunt my haven. Tell me, child, have you resolved our quest? Has the so-called developer been sent to meet his fictitious maker?
Yeah,
hallelujah! Truth prevails over false idols yet again, and the Church of Hazel Tome stands another night in all its glory, a beacon to the undesirables and deplorables of the world. Well done, fledgling. And did you inquire into the persistence of the matter? What drives a man so tenaciously towards his own doom? Truly, the world deals in mysteries that not even Hazel Tomes and his disciples are meant to unravel. But those with an eye for the world beyond this one have ways to search for the verity of it all. I believe you've given me something to sink my curious fangs into.
If you say so.
You've proven yourself a loyal disciple. Please, allow my adorations to ordain you into our unholy congregation. Be no stranger to the Church of Hazel Tomes, for you are a welcome guest in this sanctuary, and this pack may have use of your talents another night.
I'm out of here. With the red lights. Alright, so let's see what's in the building with the red lights. There was something about this house.
Welcome to Chateau de Mac. You just wandering here because you look lost, like you're looking for something. Maybe I can help you find whatever it is you're looking for.
Oh, okay, Mac, I'll bite.
I can tell you're not like most girls, are you? You want something the boys ain't selling, and you got fantasies too kinky for your girlfriend, huh? Whatever gets you wet and wild, it's none of my business. As long as you got the money, you'll always leave satisfied.
Well... Oh, you're kidding. It's a remake of 90s. Oh, boy. So, we've got some business to discuss.
Business, huh? What are you supposed to be? Some feminazi bitch here to shut down the man? Look, girlie, why don't you get back to baking cookies in the kitchen where you belong before somebody gets hurt?
No, it's nothing like that. Victoria sent me. She wants you to cut one of your girl's lips.
Oh yeah, that's real cute. You know, women think they can put on their best shoes and a mean face and talk business like they're one of the boys. And you, working for her? Fucking adorable. You both ought to just get under a man where you belong.
I ought to smack you. Yep, same bitch boss and stuff. Yeah, you'll walk all over. You want to prove you're more of a man than me? Tell me what you want in exchange for Ariana.
Ah, this again? Look, for the last time, Ariana ain't for sale. You go back to that bitch and tell her if she wants some alone time, she can pay the same price as everyone else. But I'm not giving up my Latina princess.
She's just one girl. It's gotta be something you want.
Victoria's been a fucking pain in my ass about this chica. Wish I knew what was so fucking special about her, but yeah, I can think of something that might make it worth my while.
What's that?
The girl's a USDA grade A cut of ass. But more importantly, she fills a certain niche. You gotta understand, my clients have certain proclivities. Some gents come down to East LA looking for a piece of that sweet Latina action, and the Mac's gotta provide.
What are you getting at here?
I'm saying, Victoria's really pushing my buttons on this one. And I need some goodwill around here, so yeah, I could give you the girl. But I still need some Latina bitch to fit the bill. You find someone else to fill her Mexican thong, Maybe we can talk about cutting her loose.
Are you kidding me?
Do what you gotta do. Tell them what they need to hear, use your disciplines, threats, hell, bash her fucking head in, and drag her here if you have to. I can take care of the rest. But she's gotta be brown, and she better be cut. No fatties. I don't want to see you dragging anything less than a 7 my way.
You're an asshole. Is there any place you normally recruit from?
Yeah, anywhere's fine if you know where to look. Just take a look around the neighborhood. This is Beaner territory, so you shouldn't have to dig too deep. Hey, deal's a deal. That much you can hold me to. And remember, you need the hookup, then you know the Max got your supply.
But yeah, that was a Nine Inch Nails remix going on. Cool. Probably one of their most well-known songs. It's a big one.
Something on your mind? Tackle. Give me a call. 323-405-DPRK.
I'm not interested in the woman on the radio. Bathroom? Nope, no bathroom. That doesn't sound good. Oh, hey.
Oh, sorry, didn't see you there. Did you, want to place an order or something? Oh, everything is good here. The tacos can be a bit chewy though. The taquitos are good, but only if you like them soggy. You can also get a burrito, but only order the beef burrito. Do not order pollo, okay? Or you can get a chimichanga. We have grande, enorme, gigante. Oh, also there's flan.
Wait, chimichanga? Deadpool? Who are you? Well, that's not worked.
Oh, sorry, didn't see you there. Did you, want to place an order or something?
You just spoke to me. You are cute, but what's your name?
I'm Martina. See, it says so right here on my name tag.
I don't see a name tag. Oh, God, this doesn't sound good. You're really cute. You know what you've got. Spunk. I'll have a go with spunk. Say, are you looking for a change?
Oh, I don't know. It's not much, but I like working here. I like my little life. Are you offering me, a job?
See, that's exactly the kind of positive attitude that I'm looking for. I help find people with talent. I know a guy that's looking to fill a sales position. I think you'd be perfect.
You really want me? I always knew my smile would take me far in life, but I never thought it would land me a job. Who's this friend of yours?
By saving someone. Does that make me feel any better? If it is entirely by their own choice or poverty.
I know you can feel it too. The fog of doom like a dead weight condensing around this blighted city. Who will you trust to guide the Sword of Cain in these final nights? Put your faith in me and fear not.
Yeah, well, you know how it is, Hazel. I don't want to get involved in the politics here. I'm only around long enough to turn a buck and get back on my feet. Everyone wants something. In the end, it comes down to who can deliver the goods.
Even in the abyss, you won't escape the politics and bickering. Not so long as you live among your fellow canines here in the Angel's City. Worship the dollar at your altar of inequities, but it won't buy you salvation on Gehenna's Eve. You say you believe in our Father's shackles. Believe also in me. I alone have the judgment to guide us through.
Yeah, Hazel, I know. Let me sleep on it. I'm sure we can work something out.
I bid you good eve, K-Knight.
This girl you brought by, yeah, wasn't quite what I was looking for. But she'll do, for now. Anyways, you're alright. I think this'll make things a lot easier around here for both of us. Hazel? Yeah. Fucking Malkavian. He's as whacked out as they come. Now he's coming around here, wanting me to back him while he vies for bishop of this corner of LA. A guy like that? Best just tell him what he wants to hear. You can count on one thing, though. With a bunch of canines clamoring to be on top, things are gonna get nasty around here real fast. Real unfortunate. Guy was inside this warehouse on the other side of town when a bomb went off. Camarilla job from what I hear.
spot of some kind of warning or payback. A lot of whispered rumors around that, but I guess you wouldn't know anything about that, would you? Hey, I'm a man of my word. I'll have Rihanna pack her shit up and meet you outside. It's a pleasure doing business. And if you ever need your fix, sex, blood, a bit of the ultraviolence, you know where to come.
I don't look. Damn it! Damn it! I can't destroy you, you.
What? What's happening? Who are you? Where are we? What do you mean, home? This place looks strange. This isn't home, is it?
No, you've been away from home. Oh, okay. Can you find a way back to your place in the project or something?
Yeah, I think. This is looking familiar. I can see the gate down the street, so my building shouldn't be far. Wait. Can you tell me what happened in this house? My stomach, it's nothing up just looking at this place. Yeah, I feel like I need to lay down. I don't know who you are, but thanks.
You've done well. The Mac says you're a woman not to be crossed. And more importantly, Ariana's home. For that, you have my thanks.
There's nothing really.
Perhaps the Camarilla elite can dismiss a boon so easily. But among the Sabbat, loyalty is what makes the world turn, and you've done me no small favor. Keep earning my trust, and soon you'll have a place here. But I'm sure there's many things you'd like to know. You have my ear. Don't waste it.
Yeah, I can respect you. So, who exactly are you?
I head this chapter of the Latin Kings and their drug trade. But that's all a facade. My true title is Ductus of the Pack I lead. Our enemies have learned to fear me. But my soldiers know well enough to respect me. To respect a firm hand and a sharp knife. That's the power every good leader bears.
What's a ductus?
The ductus is the one the pack looks to for answers. It's a seat of power I've kept warm for many years. But the bishop is the one who controls the domain. The one that all the ducti must support. It's time Los Discípulos are at the front of East L.A. With the bishop dead, that is now possible.
But someone else wants the job as well.
Claro que sí. Hazel, padre loco, he moved his pack in on this turf. That hideous Malkavian madness runs deep if he finds himself worthy of the title of bishop. And deeper still if he thinks sucking up to me, André, and any of the other Sabbat will get him anywhere. Think of the Sabbat como un puño. Many fingers. Each one moves on its own, but true strength comes when they strike together. Each pack of the Sabbat has a few old soldiers. The ones you see around here, these are mine. Los discípulos de Xicoat. Los discípulos de Xicoat son los Sabbat brutal enough, sharp enough to be counted among mi familia. We run los depas here. We run the drugs. We snuff out anyone that gets in our way. And if you're smart, you'll stay on our good side.
What can you tell me about your turf?
El Barrio, East LA. It's modest, perhaps, but it's earnest. This is where the downtrodden and forgotten are cast off. In the air, you taste that desperation? That desperation is our lifeblood. These depas we nest in. A perfect example. The mortal government's consolation, with the best of intention, to the many wretched relegated here. But we've corrupted it completely. Through drugs, through apathy. The cattle here we keep on a short rope. Your timing here, it's extraño. The winds of change have come. Perhaps it's no coincidence they've blown you to my door, when it's you I have to thank.
Winds of change?
In the warehouse, the bomb you placed. It killed many soldiers that night, my superior and the Sabbat included. You opened a door that had been shut for decades. Unfortunately, I'm not the only one fighting for a slice of power. The Ductus is the one the pack looks to for answers. It's a seat of power I've kept warm for many years. But the bishop is the one who controls the domain, the one that all the Ducti must support. El Barrio. These depas. There's nothing on the street about it. You're the one holding all the clues, I'm afraid. But perhaps we can see each other's paths to their ends.
I like the sound of that. What do you have in mind?
The blood flows from apathy, but the drugs are the current to pull it along. Someone, brave or foolish enough, has damned themselves, stealing from me. The delivery from the south has disappeared, and our pack will suffer until this drought is cleared. Find the thief, and slaughter them.
Murder! Now we're talking. What can you tell me about the courier?
I don't concern myself with the details. Go talk to one of the juice bags, Arturo. He'll tell you what you need to know. You can find him in El Número Cuatro.
Four? Yes. Who is Arturo?
Él es un enforcer de kings. He's loyal. He follows the tide of our drugs carefully. He can be trusted. He will help you.
Got it. I'll be back.
Espere. The Sabbat. In the day, we share a common haven. A nest. Apartamento Cinco is yours to rest in and keep your things. This is my boon to you for Ariana's safe return. Even if you still have my trust to earn.
Thank you. not gonna never dicks. And your face immediately transformed. Hey.
Master? Okay.
Hola. ¿Qué haces en mi apartamento?
Sorry, what? Can we speak English?
Sorry. Can I help you?
We don't speak Espanol. Oh, yeah, there isn't it? I guess no one told you.
No. Who the hell are you, then? Wait, what? How do you know about all that? Yeah, I'm Ariana. Why do I get the feeling we've crossed paths somehow? I don't really know. It's a strange thing. I was in that place for so long, but I guess I just sort of blocked a lot of it out. I can't really talk about that yet, okay? Man, who knows what I was thinking. Kicking ass at school, rocking the scene was my life as a kid. Next day, I'm a streetwalker with too much to prove. Way to adult, Ariana. At least the money was good.
What could you possibly need all that money for?
Not the career path for me, I guess. But I do still need more money if I'm gonna make it to college. You know, some people want to change the world, but I'll settle for just fixing things up around here. That's the best any of us can really hope for. Who knows? Psychology, urban farming, sociology, I don't know. Too many choices. All I know is I don't want to forget where I came from.
I hope you can forget about what you did to make that money.
Like you never did anything you regret. Nostalgia, regret. If this crap is for adults, I already miss being a little kid. Thanks, I guess. School's a breeze. The teachers tell me I don't really belong here, but this is home. For better or for worse, you know? Last I checked, my dad's somewhere in Mexico City, but I never knew him. Mom, well, she was a bystander 5 years ago. Stray bullet. But it's not all bad. My big brother, he's always watched out for me. Made sure I have what I need. Arturo, maybe you know him. Seems like everybody around here does. I can't say I agree with him all the time, but he's never been anything less than a good brother to me.
Can't say that I know him, but I'll say hi if we cross paths. Speaking of which, I'm at the door. That's the one. Okay, so let's say hi to Arturo. Maybe I should say hi to him first. I will not be surprised if some of these, if this or future videos get age restricted because of this.